Learn how to use secure configuration for Azure Functions with Azure Key Vault in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. You can secure secrets in Azure Key Vault and read them easily in an Azure function. Let's see how to do that. Here we are in Visual Studio 2019. I'm going to create a new Azure function in here. You can also use Visual Studio Code or another tool to do this if you want. Let's give it a name, like this. Create, and now I'll pick the HTTP trigger, and I'll set this to anonymous so that we can test it easily. Here we go, and OK. This is the function. I'll add a couple of lines of code in here. These read the application setting called MySecret from the function's configuration, and will show the value in the log. All right, that's it. Let's publish it. I'm going to create a new Azure function from here. And here we go. I'll just pick my resource group, OK, and select another location. That's it. OK, create this. Here it goes. Whilst this is working, we'll switch to the Azure portal. Here we are going to create an Azure Key Vault, like this. OK, I'll select my resource group again, and I'll give the Key Vault a name. OK, the rest seems good. Let's create it. All right, and there it goes. Let's switch to the Azure function. This has now been published to Azure. Here we need to go to Platform Features and Identity. Because here we can create an Azure Managed Service Identity for the function. We'll use this to connect to Azure Key Vault without needing API keys. OK, and that's it. Now back to the Key Vault that has now been deployed. Here we go. In here, let's go to Access Policies. And let's add one here. I'm going to add an access policy for the Azure Function Managed Identity. This one. And this one will be able to do whatever it wants with Key Vault secrets. Here we go. OK, and save it. Now to add a secret. Here we go. Generate and import. OK. I'll name it My Secret. And I'll give it a value like this, which is secret value. OK, let's create it. There we go. Let's take a look at it. The secret has one version, this one, and these are the details. We need the secret identifier, so I'll copy it. And now go back to the Azure function. Here we are. And go to configuration. All right. Here we'll add a new item. The name of the item will be My Secret. This has nothing to do with the Key Vault secret, but it has to do with the value that the code in the Azure function will read. Now, here is the nifty part. In the value, I put this. This format references the Azure Key Vault and gets the secret with the identifier that we've just copied. So I don't have to connect to the Key Vault in any way, I just use this format and the managed service identity and that's it. Alright, let's save it. Alright, let's test this. This is the function. And let's run it. Here we go. OK, let's take a look at the log. And here it is, the secret value that comes directly from Azure Key Vault. Connecting Azure Key Vault to Azure Functions is easy. Go and check it out.